Yes. So, hello everyone and welcome to this year's Impact Revit presentation. My name is Desi Swaba and I'm a part of Impact Revit team in Horsens, Denmark. It has been four official releases and here we are 1 year later talking about news and future plans. If we have to look back in 2018, we'll say that it has been a great year for Impact Revit. Our users worldwide has increased, our team has grown, and our visions for the software has greatly expanded. But today is not about looking back, today is about looking forward and talking about why we say that Impact Revit is the precast tool of the future. We are gathered a lot of people today with different software experiences. And for those of you that have never worked with Revit before, I would say that this presentation is very relevant because today you're going to see a new way to draw precast elements, more visual, easier to understand, easier to navigate. And I can also see some Revit users, some Impact Revit users here today. And for you, I've also prepared some features. And some of the features are actually so new that we just added them yesterday to the program. And I decided to take them today. So there's also going to be a lot for you to see. But let's see the big picture. Today we're going to talk about what is Impact Revit. That's the question my presentation is going to answer. And let's take a look at it. This is how a project in Impact Revit is going to look like. This is an interface. And as Peter mentioned before, all our files, they are in one single Revit file. If you look at the project browser in here, you find elevations, you have plans, you have 3D views, you have end caps, everything in one place, always updated, easy to see with one click. Impact Revit is our newest detailing and modeling tool. And if we take even closer look to Impact Revit, then this is it. Impact is an add-in to Revit. Once you have Revit installed, you can install Impact. And what you can get is the tools. We have developed tools for modeling, detailing, reinforcement, shop drawings, production, every phase of the precast design. And let's start with seeing what we can draw in Impact Revit. We have seven element types available in the software right now, and I want to go through each one of them quickly. So we're going to draw a little project on the screen today, and the first element type we're going to see are columns. And where we have columns, probably we also have beams. Columns and beams, they are the most established element type that we have in the Impact Revit software. Back then, we started modeling columns and beams is a couple of years ago. And now we have a lot of tools. We have reinforcement tool for columns and beams. What the reinforcement tool can do is, let's take this column. If this is a family called 30 by 30 centimeters, once you reinforce this column, you don't need to draw reinforcement on all the other columns. You can just save the configuration and apply it to the other columns. And pay attention here, it's not necessary that those columns have the same size. If this was 30 by 30, it's important that the base geometry is the same. It's important that we have a rectangular column, then we make one family with different types. And then our reinforcement configuration, it can be applied to each type of the family. So if this is 30 by 30 and this is 40 by 40, you can just use the reinforcement configuration. We have also tools for making corbels, and here are they here. If you've forgotten your glasses today, here how they look. This is how a corbel could look like in Impact Revit. We have a tool that you can select a corbel, and then by selecting column and beam, you can just automatically insert the corbel. The next element type I would like to talk about is a fundamental for the precast industry, and that's of course the walls. In Impact Revit, we have solid walls, insulated walls, and sandwich walls. And some of you might think, it's the same that you have in Impact AutoCAD. And you're right. The same element types that we can draw in AutoCAD, we can also draw in Impact Revit. But not only that, we can also import walls, wall definitions from the database in Impact Revit. What does it mean? Well, let's say that I want to draw a wall in my Impact Revit model. I can draw the definition, I can make the definition from scratch, make the lift settings, make the in-cap settings, reinforcement template settings. But if I already have this definition, if there are some of my colleagues that have been drawing this wall in AutoCAD, I can just import it in Impact Revit and just draw it. Don't need to make the definition from scratch. So that's good to remember here. And it's very good actually that you made Project Pizza, because I was just about to say that we can split the walls also in Revit, and we can make in caps and joints. So all the basic functionality that you have in Impact AutoCAD is also to be found in Impact Revit. But because we have Revit as a base, we can do more, and we've taken this possibility. We have tools like parametric in-caps. We have tools that can make a multi-layer wall. What does it mean? It means that in the usual Impact software, you have three layers, but in Impact Revit, you can add an underlayer to a layer. So suddenly, you can have seven-layer wall, if that's what you want. Moreover, we have tools for copy-pasting elements. So once you draw these walls in here, you can just copy-paste them. You can move them also up, down in the building, and then add the windows. So no need to draw them all over again. Yes, so once we are here, we probably want to have some slabs. And luckily, that's something that we have in Impact Revit Holocores, and slabs are to be found. If we have to say a few words about this element type, we'll say that we have in-caps that you can apply to Holocores and solid slabs. In the Holocore family, you can make older settings that you usually do in Impact AutoCAD. But if you want to draw a Holocore in Impact Revit, keep in mind that you can also generate this Holocore once you save it in Impact AutoCAD. And then you say, why would you do that? Well, let's say that you have an established drawing office that is making Holocores, and you have shop drawing templates, and you can't wait to start using Revit, but you don't have a standard yet. Well, just draw the Holocores in Revit, save them, they're going to appear in the database, and then you're ready to finish the design in AutoCAD. Yes, Now comes a very interesting type of element, that's the linked elements. And linked elements, they can be anything in Impact Revit. And when we say anything, we really mean anything. Here we have a dinosaur, that's actually a family in Revit. So what you see here is Revit, and this is Project Manager. So once you draw an element, no matter if it's linked or ordinary type, you just save it, it comes in the database, and then you see this type of element in Project Manager. And here you can see our friend, it has an element mark, L1 has an ID number, all elements have an ID number in the Impact project. And then you can use the great production tools in Project Manager to plan the elements. So anything, you can have the whole zoo if that's what you want, but probably you want to use linked elements for column shoes, for steel beams, anything that you don't want to save as a concrete element, but you want to see. And here comes the new element type for this year, and that's of course the form slab. Well, back then when we started developing the form slab, we took a trip to some of our users, we made research, we visit some of your companies and factories, and we took a talk with you, and we asked, what do you miss in the software that you have now? And we got a lot of inspiration from you, and the things that you missed, we've actually incorporated from start in Impact Revit. And these are some features that I selected and would like to share with you today. So let's start with the first one, showing the full height of the form slab. Now the form slab, it consists of this plate and the lattice girders, but also is the top layer, which now you can see in Revit, this is the layer that casts its concrete cast in situ on the building site. So if I'm a designer and I'm in doubt, this is an in-cap here, I've applied an in-cap to a sandwich wall in Impact Revit. If I'm in doubt if my detail is correct and I have place in here, then I'll just switch on my 3D model. There is fully updated 3D model all the time in the Revit project, so why not use it? I'm gonna switch also the full height of the form slab, and I'm gonna take a look at this. I'm still not convinced. Then I can just make a section in Revit, right click, go to sections automatically generated, and then I can still see the full height of the form slab. When I get tired of seeing it, I just switch it off. So this is one way of checking the design. The next one is finding the depth of the lattice girder and controlling it on a single piece. We found out that a lot of you would like to sing one or two lattice girders in the form slab. And here why using Revit as a base platform comes in use, because we made a parameter that you can just go in, type in a value, and then the lattice girder is synced. And where you can use that? Well, if you have a floor construction where you need a slope, well, you can just sync one or two, and you can show the slope and the placement of the lattice girder in the 3D model and in your shop drawing. The next one I really like, it's converting form slab to pre-stress form slab. And I really wish I had this one back when I was drawing, because I know that all you precast designers here, you feel the same when you get this call from somebody calculating the elements saying, oh, they have to be pre-stressed now. And that would mean that if you take a look at the slabs where we have to delete them and you have to start all over. But And you're actually going to be lucky if the elements look like this, but most of the time you're going to have recess openings, or you're going to have an MVP key, and then you have to remove and switch and draw and add. No need for that. You can just go to the definition and convert to pre-stress. If you don't have a pre-stress form slab definition, you just import from the database. You probably have one if you are established drawing office in Impact AutoCAD. So that easy it is. This one is something that is again inspired from you, users of Impact Revit and Impact AutoCAD. We found out that a lot of you would like to have a new element mark when you draw form slab for some reasons, and but this setting you need only on form slabs. You don't need this for other type of elements. And then we developed a setting in Impact Revit that can control how you name form slabs only, instead of controlling how you name the whole Impact project. So this is to be found. Then we have edit boundaries. This is a very good setting where you draw the elements. If there's come some change, if this wall has to be moved, you can just switch on the mode, edit the boundary, update, and then the form slabs are in place. You can edit multiple form slabs on place. Install multiple elements, draw multiple holes, a lot of features here to explore, and all those are coming in the release, December release. It's a week from now, so form slab users, it's probably something you'd like to look at. Yes. So we have seven element types in Impact Revit. We have columns and beams. They are to be found here, pre-stress beams. We have holocores. We have three types of walls, slabs, form slab, linked element. All those elements, they are to be found in here, following menus and functions, precast functions needed to model and draw the elements, they are to be found in the following menu. And now let's continue with the shop drawing. That's also a very important part of the Impact Revit software. And here how a typical Impact Revit shop drawing would look like. It's important to know that here we keep the idea of Impact, and that's work smarter and not harder. And that's why we have our shop drawing based on templates. It means that your Impact Revit administrator is going to prepare a template for you. And then, when I generate the shop drawing, views, details, schedules, they come automatically. If we take a look here, we'll see that we have details. These are the edge details, we call in caps. Views, dimensions, they come automatically, and our goal is that the precast designer must do as less as possible manual work. Now if we take a look at here, we'll see some differences, some new things. Let's take a look in the 3D view. We have spot elevations, they're called. There are elevation values. We can see the bottom and the top, they come automatically in the 3D view. That's a big help to orientate in the element. We also have some top elevation for the MVP key. Another difference here could be the dimension lines. In order to have less dimension lines on the top or on the left, then we made an option in the template to automatically dimension inside the element. So this is an option that you can choose, and in this case, if I have two openings, then I can just have dimension inside, and then Impact Revit will also group the dimensions, like it's in the case here. Yes, so but that's only one small example of what we've done with the shop drawings. would like to show this picture, and here actually starts the history of the next development. We found out that a lot of you struggle with some casting materials that you forget to send to the building site. This is some small parts of the fixtures that you need in order to mount the elements, and it ends up your mounting crews calling home to the company, and then you get resources. You have to spend on it, it's time and money, and nobody likes that. And what could be this small pieces of casting materials? I've taken the typical examples. We have some HTA, and usually you choose one size and you cast it in the wall. This is a top view. And then you need to remember to take the boards, two pieces usually, with you on the building site. If you don't have the right size, you cannot mount the element. Another example could be this solution, where you have a plate casted in the wall, then you have an L plate. You need to remember to take on the building site. But the thing is that remembering is not that easy, and actually forgetting, they say, some scientists that they say forgetting is the most important function of our brain. So if we don't forget, our brain will just explode. So that's something you can use next time you forget something. Just say, my most important function in the brain, it's working fine. But yeah, but that doesn't solve this guy's problem, because he still misses this small part. And then we thought, where? So we put this erection casting material, we call them. Where's how we put them? So that you remember them. And then we thought, why not put them on the shop drawing? And here are they. Here we have a casting material schedule. We have the HTA, and on the bottom, just below, we have, remember, two parts. There's a bolt we need to take. Or the plate in here, remember the L plate, one piece you're gonna need. In this way, we're always going to see what type of erection casting materials are connected with the casting material in the wall. And the next step is making schedules in on the project level. So this is something we're working right now. We're making filters in the schedules so that I can say to this schedule, show me how many erection casting materials I have in level one, because I'm going to send elements to the building site next week, and then they're going to come. Or another filter could be, show me how many erection casting materials I have in all holocores, then it's going to come. So this is something you can be looking forward. If you have any ideas, you're also welcome to come with them today. Yes, so that was a little bit about the shop drawing. Now we need to talk about the software integration. Well, we have a Revit, Impact Revit, and we said that once we save the element, they go in the database and we can see them in Project Manager. But probably many of you doesn't know that we also have a possibility to have an Impact AutoCAD linked file to this project. So if this is my project, I have the files in here, I can just link as many as I want, Revit and AutoCAD files. And if I have the same XREF positioned on the same place, I can see the project in here. As you can see, I have holocores, beams and columns, holocores, beams and columns. The XREF is placed the same way. I draw the walls and they come in here. So this is a way of using both Impact AutoCAD and Impact Revit in one Impact project. What you can also do is you can draw the elements in Revit, save them, and then in AutoCAD there's one generate button in here. So once the elements are in the database, you can generate and see them in Impact AutoCAD. And that would mean that then you can finish the design. And this is one or two examples of a lot of possibilities that you have with the Impact Revit software. And I've actually made a sum up with three different directions, I'll call them, and here are they. And you say, whoa, wasn't it one software you were talking about? It is one software, but you see a lot of possibilities in it. So once you have the Impact Revit model, you can produce a sub drawing. That's what I'm talking about. But then we have the hybrid solution. That's why I use both Impact AutoCAD and Revit. And this is a presentation in itself. So this is something my colleague Thomas is going to talk in the afternoon today. The third one is the Revit model. If you receive a model from outside and it has Revit drawings and it has shop drawings and you just want to produce these elements, you're not interested in making design, you save them and you switch them, show them in the project manager. Or if you want to apply a specific impact definition, you can also do that because we have a tool for that in Impact Revit. So a lot of possibilities, and you can be looking forward to the presentation at 3 o'clock where we're going deep in this hybrid solution. Yes, and the last thing I would like to mention about Impact Revit is that we have a very user-friendly interface. And the first feature I've selected to show today is the Impact Library browser. Here how it looks like. What is it? It is all your company standards in one place. When you insert a casting material today, you see one piece that you insert in the element. But we thought, what if you can see all the casting materials? This is where you do it. You can see all the components. This could be joints, casting materials, in caps, you name it. All your standard is in this window, and then you have common, local, and project niveau. And once you are in here, you can edit the component, insert, duplicate, rename, delete. You can operate your standard from the project. You don't need to go to the file where you have it. And moreover, you can also see the parameters of this, if this is a family, in here. And this is going to be very good for, if you have, for example, if this is a casting material and the parameter is the setting of it, if you have a setting saying that it has to be on the top of the element, then you have totally the same, but saying that the casting material must be sinked down 5 or 10 millimeters. Well, then you can see it in here. It's going to appear once you press on it. So all your company standard in one window in your project. That's what Impact Library Browser is. The next one I would like to mention today is the ribbon customization. And this is a feature that you, all you can use in a different way. And it's because we all you talk different languages. So we have the ribbon. It usually looks like this. It's in English. But what if you have the ribbon in Swedish, in Danish, or in Chinese? That's possible now in Impact Revit. You can translate the functions and save the configuration, save the translation, and send it to your users if you are Impact Revit administrator. But that's not the only thing that ribbon customization does. What you can also do is delete some functions. And let's say I'm a designer that has a main task in walls and form slabs. I don't need to see all those beams and columns. I can put a sticky note on the screen if that's going to solve my solution. That's going to be a solution, but it's not. And we think how to make it easier for you to go directly to the function that you want, where we can delete them, and then it's going to look like this. You just remove everything that you don't need. And then we have the ribbon. This is how it looks now. And as I said in the start, our team is growing. We've never been more people than now working on this project. We have users joining almost every month this Impact Revit software. And that's going to mean only one thing. It's going to be crowded in this ribbon. And we think, why don't organize those functions? So I've done here is I have a ribbon called shop drawing or reinforcement. So all my reinforcement functions there in one tab and all my shop drawings there in another. It's easy for me if I'm on the working on the shop drawing, I'm just going to press on it and then it's easy to see what function to use, more clear for you. Yes, and I would like to take a few minutes talking about how to start up this Impact Revit change. We've been talking with a lot of you, and this has been a question that I think we can make a solution for. So we have experience in companies changing software. And the first thing that we think everybody needs when you change software, not only Impact Revit, but is education. You need to know what the software can in order to see how you can use it. We've had some users that started directly for a couple of years ago, and then if you don't have the education, you don't have the possibility to see what's behind those all those functions. And we have geared up, we are making education, we're writing courses, and here I'd like to present some possibilities that we have. So 2019, it's going to be dedicated on education for us. We start actually in 18. The first course we're going to need to do is the Revit intro. That's basically what we have today with a practical experience. So when you go home after those courses, it's a 1-day course in December and February. You're gonna know what Impact Revit is, and you have the possibility to draw the basic, to use the basic functionality of the software. The second is the Impact Beginner. And we had some users saying, I have to use it. Well, I want to go to the beginner. Say that's totally fine, because in the beginner, we're making courses in March, both in Denmark and Sweden. We're going to go in deep, and we're going to use the most as we can of the functionalities in order to learn you how to draw with Impact Revit, to show you what we can. The third one is administrator, and here you can see if it's in May again in Impact and Sweden. And if you are, it looks like a little bit like a traffic light. So it's, you have to imagine that if you've never been using the software, you're probably somewhere here. But once you take the administrator, well, then you also will know how to make shop drawing templates. You also know how to make families. And that's here you probably want to send the administrator of Impact Revit. We also have for coaching and company specific courses. And it's a possibility to find information about the software in Impact Wiki, which is the educational platform for Struesoft. All those courses, they are on the Struesoft webpage, so you can actually come and sign up already today. The company specific and coaching is something we agree on with you, and they are usually not on the webpage. This is something we arrange with the users. Company standard is a standard that looks a little bit like the one in AutoCAD. You can reuse some parts, but you can also, at some point, you're going to need to make your own. So in the start, you're going to use the free company standard that we provide, but we have also possibility to make your own standard or get the help from Struesoft, because we provide resources for that. But that's number 2 and 3, is how to start out. The first and most important, I would say, is to find the right person to go in front. You know, it's when you change a software, when you have a software with so many possibilities that we have in Impact Revit and Revit as a whole, then you need to find somebody to that's going to see the glass half full and not, you know, half empty. Somebody that's going to take the challenges and somebody that's going to grab all the possibilities that you have. On the other hand, a change is always a graduate change. So you don't close a drawing office and say, we're learning. You choose the right person, and at the start it's going to be one or two, and then you're going to gradually get more and more people involved. That's how the best way to implement a new software. That's what our experience says. And then this person in front is also going to be the one that's going to motivate the others, and is going to solve every challenges that comes, and is going also to take the communication with us. Yes, and I would say we're looking forward to 2019. We have a lot of plans with you. We have a lot of internal plans, and probably some of you remember, if you've seen the presentation last year, this graphic. That's our graphic of growing in Impact Revit. And some of you already asked today, how big is the child? So I would say it's not a child anymore. We are actually a graduate, and it's 2018. We've had a lot of moments where we had our hands in the air, and we were very happy with the things that our development team achieved. But as any graduate, we know that the fun starts just now, and we are really looking to cooperate and to continue working with you and all of you that are probably thinking about joining this project. We are all going one way, and this is this ultimate Impact Revit experience. And in the end, I would like to say two things. The first one is about change. You know, this software is changing. 4 times a year we release, 4 times a year we improve. And if we are thinking that we do things correct and there is no place for improvement, we're probably wrong. So take a look at this and find out what Impact Revit can do for you. On the other hand, we are changing the software, we're putting more and more functions, but we know our direction, but is it exactly the direction that you need? There's only one way that we can find out, and if it's you, take contact to us. So do not hesitate to try it out. If you have Impact AutoCAD, you also have Impact Revit, it's a base license. Don't hesitate to try it out and find out what Impact Revit can do for you. Yes, so I think thank you for your attention. How is with the time?
Yeah, we have time.
We have time?
5 minutes.
5 minutes, yeah, okay. Do we have questions?
Hi. How about the double walls?
Yes, double walls are the element that comes in 2019. And we've actually started looking at it. And we have some plans. For example, the settings that I've showed you about, a specific setting for element mark, the same we're going to have for double walls. So these two elements, we've heard that you would like a specific setting for that. And when we started developing the form slab, we thought, let's start with the form slab, because this is, from technical point of view, it's going to be more challenging for us. So once we have the form slab on place, then we continue with double wall. And we have definitely plans to fulfill them. Yes?
How about work sharing?
Yes, very good question. Work sharing is available in Impact Revit. So basically it's the same rules as in Revit. This is the way a lot of companies working. So once you have a central model established, if this is an Impact Revit Central model, then we have developed a function that makes it even easier for you to collaborate. We have a function called Project Files that can open. If you select the central file and press on open, it will automatically create a local file on your computer. And in that way, the central file will be protected. It's sacred, right? So that's a function that you can try out. It's Project Files.
If you have a sandwich man with grid ties here in London, can you use the multi-layer function to just show the grid ties in one layer?
Yes.
And get it on a separate view on the
If you have the three panels of the sandwich wall, then you go in the wall definition and you make an underlayer. And then on the outer panel, then you can make a panel with the thickness of a brick, and then you can apply material. So once the material is applied, then you're also gonna show it as a brick. Brick, yeah. Yes, so that's a possibility. Yes. Now there is one question here.
Between the structural part and the impact adding, let's say we have a cast on side wall and want to change it to a precast.
It's actually that we prefer a structural model. That's what we prefer. And once you have the structural model, then we have a function called map definitions. So you can select the wall, and this is the function that's going to apply automatically a definition from the impact database. If you don't have, let's say, you don't have a thickness of 40 centimeters, well, then impact will automatically create one for you. So either you apply existing or the software will automatically create one for you. So it's possible. Yes, but I think that probably have more questions, and let's take them during the day. We have the whole day, we have also the dinner. So don't hesitate to come to us and talk about what we have and what we can do with Impact Revit. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.